history of how Earth Day came about. Air quality. Prior to the 1970s, Americans were driving huge V8 sedans using massive amounts of leaded gasoline. Aerial insecticide spraying was common over forests, cities, and suburbs. Application of insecticides to crops were at concentrations far above what was considered safe. The post-World War II industrial boom in the United States led to major air pollution. Industry belched out smoke and dumped sludge with no fear of consequences. Air pollution? That's the smell of prosperity. Mainstream America was oblivious to environmental concerns. Insecticide. DDT was first synthesized in 1874. In 1939, Paul Hermann Mueller discovered it would kill insects, such as flies and mosquitoes. In 1948, he won the Nobel Prize for his work. Because of his discovery, World War II was the first U.S. war in which diseases like typhus and malaria, carried by insects, killed fewer people than bullets and bombs. During World War II, DDT, applied to the skin in powder form, was an effective means to control lice in soldiers. It was so effective that DDT was put on the market and promoted for other insecticidal uses. Residential use of insecticides in everything from shelf paper to aerosol bombs for the home had become commonplace. Malaria was a real problem for the people of the United States during the summer and year-round in the southern warmer climates. Massive campaigns of aerial spraying over farms, in neighborhoods, and over cities were instituted. The war on mosquitoes and all other insects began. Children played in the clouds of DDT sprayed on neighborhoods. In 1947, the DDT is good for me ad runs in Time magazine. DDT is good for bigger, juicier apples. Beef grows meatier, healthier, more comfortable homes, 20% more milk and butter. Row crops, 25 more barrels of potatoes per acre. Industries gained bug-free work conditions. DDT is so safe you can eat it. DDT was seemingly innocuous to humans. What we know now is in concentrations of 6 to 10 milligrams, DDT leads to headaches, nausea, vomiting, confusion, and tremors. It is stored in fatty organs like the thyroid, adrenal, and also in the kidneys and liver. How a body reacts is based on the weight of the individual. 236 grams of DDT per kilogram of body weight is deadly for humans. In 1958, a letter written by Olga Owens Huckins to the Boston Herald described the deaths of birds on her property resulting from the aerial spraying of DDT to kill mosquitoes. She sent a copy of her letter to Rachel Carson, a marine biologist, who was then inspired to study the effects of pesticides on the environment. In the 1962 publication of Rachel Carson's New York Times bestseller, Silent Spring, Carson focused her attention on environmental conservation, especially environmental problems that she believed were caused by the overuse of synthetic pesticides. Carson talked about other pesticides, but it was DDT, sprayed aerially over large areas of the United States to control disease-carrying mosquitoes, that became the focus of this excess. She was not against the use of pesticides. She was pointing out that perhaps they were being overused, improperly applied. She made it easy for the average person to understand that this may pose a problem. No one had ever thought that humans could create something that could create harm all over the globe and come back and get in their bodies, Carl Safina, an oceanographer and author. A month after its publication, chemical companies fought back. Pesticide manufacturers launched an attack to discredit Silent Spring and destroy its author. They called the book hysterical and patently unsound. Carson's goal is to undermine American agriculture and to further the interests of the Soviet Union, pesticide manufacturer.
It is not my contention, Carson wrote in Silent Spring, that chemical insecticides must never be used. I do contend that we have put poisonous and biologically potent chemicals indiscriminately into the hands of persons largely or wholly ignorant of their potentials for harm. We have subjected enormous numbers of people to contact with these poisons without their consent and often without their knowledge.
If man were to faithfully follow the teachings of Miss Carson, we would return to the Dark Ages, and the insects and diseases and vermin would once again inherit the earth. Miss Carson maintains that the balance of nature is a major force in the survival of man, whereas the modern chemist, the modern biologist, the modern scientist believes that man is steadily controlling nature. Dr. Robert White Stevens. What we know now. DDT residues washed into waterways, where aquatic plants and fish absorbed it. Bald eagles and other fish-eating birds were poisoned when they ate the contaminated fish. The chemical also interfered with the ability of the birds to produce strong eggshells. As a result, their eggs had shells so thin that they often broke during incubation or otherwise failed to hatch. By 1963, with only 487 nesting pairs of bald eagles remaining in the U.S., the species was in danger of extinction. Loss of habitat, shooting, and DDT poisoning contributed to the near demise of our national symbol. In 1967, the bald eagle was listed as an endangered species. Water pollution. Concern about air and water pollution had spread in the wake of disasters. 1959, oil spill on the Detroit River. 1969, offshore oil rig spill in California. 1969, Cuyahoga River in Cleveland, Ohio, bursts into flames. Lake Erie had become extremely polluted due to the heavy industry that lined its shores in Ohio, Canada, and Michigan. Factories dumped pollutants into the lake and the waterways that flowed into it without government oversight. Waste from city sewers made its way into the lake, as well as agricultural fertilizer and pesticides. In 1968, a Grand Rapids Press headline read, "Is Lake Michigan dying? Rotting algae, dead fish, and fuel oil slime coated the lake. It was a dumping place for sewage, industrial waste, and nuclear power plant wastewater." In 1969, the Rouge River was the most polluted river in the United States, and it caught fire. When you have a river that burns, for crying out loud, you have troubles. It happened on Cleveland's Cuyahoga, and now it has happened on the Rouge River. Detroit Free Press editorial, October 12, 1969. Lake Michigan is the largest body of fresh water in the United States. Lake Michigan, at the present time, is still not labeled as, and does not deserve the title of, being polluted. But unless something is done now with the potential pollution of Lake Michigan, it could become like Lake Erie, which at this time could be classified as a dead sea. President Richard Nixon, February 6, 1970. A solution. United States Senator Gaylord Nelson, after seeing the damage done by a 1969 massive oil spill in Santa Barbara, California, was inspired to organize a national teach-in that focused on educating the public about the environment. That was the beginning. Earth Day was founded and first held on April 22, 1970. On April 22, 1970, 20 million Americans took to the streets, parks, and auditoriums to demonstrate for a healthy, sustainable environment in massive coast-to-coast rallies. President Richard Nixon proposed the establishment of the Environmental Protection Agency, or EPA, on July 9, 1970, and it began operation on December 2, 1970, after Nixon signed an executive order.
The Clean Air Act of 1970 authorized the development of state and federal regulations to limit the emissions from industrial and mobile sources. Four major regulatory programs were initiated: the National Ambient Air Quality Standards, State Implementation Plans, New Source Performance Standards, and National Emissions Standards for Hazardous Air Pollutants. The Federal Water Pollution Control Act Amendments of 1972, also known as the Modern Clean Water Act, established a national commitment to restore and maintain the integrity of the nation's waters. The Clean Water Act has been instrumental in improving the health of all U.S. waters. It has stopped billions of pounds of pollution from fouling the water and dramatically increased the number of waterways that are safe for swimming and fishing.
In 1972, 8 years after Rachel Carson's death, the United States banned the domestic sale of DDT, except where public health concerns warranted its use. American companies continued to export the pesticide until the mid-1980s. Earth Day continued to grow over the years. In 1990, it went global, and 200 million people in 141 countries participated in the event, according to the Earth Day Network. Recovery. Since the 1940s, air quality in the U.S. has improved. The Great Lakes have improved. In 1969, the Rouge River was the most polluted in the United States. It is healing with the help of the Friends of the Rouge River. While industry dominates the banks of the Rouge, industrial pollutants account for only 2% of the watershed's pollution. The rest comes from the 1.4 million people in the 48 municipalities within the watershed. In July 1999, the Fish and Wildlife Service proposed to remove the bald eagle from the list of threatened and endangered species. A pair of bald eagles have been nesting successfully at Stony Creek Metro Park in Shelby Township, Michigan, since 2012. When one tugs at a single thing in nature, he finds it attached to the rest of the world. John Muir. Happy Earth Day, April 22nd, 2020, 50 years.